was wondering, can you hear me well, the ones at the end of the room? Okay, so I'm going to talk a very short presentation because of the restrictions of time, in which I'm going to consider a book as an asset class. Not all kinds of books, specific types of books, like philosophy dictionaries. And this is, I'm going to have some special cases, two of them, two books, two dictionaries. The first one that I'm going to start with is the edited volume by Adrian Parr, called the Deleuze Dictionary, the revised edition is what I have. Many people have contributed, make it smaller. Okay, that's okay. I'm going to get rid of that in a while. Many people have contributed to this edited volume, and at least one of them, yes, John. John is here. Hi, John. So these are the, I don't know how to call them, the entrances inserted by John. And let me start from the beginning. Yes, on creative transformation and biology, on earth, land, Terre, on fascism, on what else? Organism, etc., etc. State of geography. Yeah, I guess this is very interesting to most of the people here. Now, I mean, how to consider a book, or in particular, a philosophy dictionary as an assemblage? Well, let me show you some picture, what you're going to see. You're going to see something like, I'm sorry, like this one. Is it shown by Bacon, Beckett, so forth, Bergson, etc. But then you have body, you have black hole, you have body without organs, you have art, you have architecture, you know, the field of many of the participants here. So this is completely heterogeneous. And the way I describe the relationships, they're completely exterior relationships, the way they're not enunciated or initiated by the actants themselves, but they are actually presented in the book, in the way the book is somehow articulating the material for its entrance in the dictionary. So this can be considered to be an assemblage. It's a network assemblage. It's quite detailed. I think Bruno has tried to do something 5-6 years ago, but in terms of web pages or whatever. But here I'm trying to do in terms of a book assemblage something a little bit more detailed. So things I have found is, actually I was wondering if I can have some help to give to people who want to read a book, like a dictionary, and they have such a map, such a network. One question they might be naturally actually, they would tend to ask, is where are we going to start with such a book? We said that alphabetical order doesn't make any sense. So the question would be, can we start in an item, in an entrance of the dictionary, and then follow all the connectives in such a way to have to span the whole book and to understand the Deleuze philosophy, because this is all about it, by doing this navigation? And in terms of networks, this question is translated in something related to access through links. So if you go from one item, from one keyword, one entrance to the dictionary, to one of its connectives, which is mentioned in the contents of this one, then actually you follow a path. And if you keep on going to another one, you keep on following paths. However, if you start with one, let's say, page, then you can might access up in this way, in this case, I think it's 5 to 6 other pages. And of course, this is not uniform for all pages. Depending on where you start, you access other items, and so you need to know about that. So I made some detailed work for here, for this case. So here I have enumerated the depth of access starting from each one of the dictionary entrances. So most of it is 4 or 5, but the history is very small. And I'm going to give you some examples here. For example, if the starting node is body without organs, where I'm going? So at distance 4, I'm going to minor literatures, control society, and Lamarck. So this means that I'm doing four jumps, going from BWO to each one of those. So for example, and so forth with regards to other distances. So if I want to see something where I go from BWO to minor literatures, I go first to force, then to difference, then to minoritarian, and then to minor literatures, the way the book is, the dictionary is structured. Of course, I'm free to opt to read anything in any order of my preference, but this is actually what the network, the assemblage of this dictionary is indicating to us. And then I said, okay, so let me cut off, let me restrict all these items to just a few of them. You know, I have a tool here, but you are free to use it. I can give you access to this Zeppelin notebook, as it's called, if you're interested. And then you can collect some of those nodes, and you see what is called a subnetwork, or in graph theory it's called a subgraph, which is something, okay, I have to make it a little bit. Here, for example, you see the connectives, the relationships between assemblage, affect, lise, and so forth, how to go from one to them. So we've got rid of all the other ones, and we kept just a limited number to clear up the picture. And then there is another notion. Okay, this is, in graph theory, it's called a strongly, it's not a strongly connected graph, which means if we take two items, necessarily we're not going to find a path going from one item to another one, or from the second to the first one. However, there is a technique, there are algorithms in computational theories that we can extract a core of consisting of strongly connected items, and this is the biggest one, is called the giant strongly connected component. And here, okay, this is from this is the hole. Now this is, okay, it's more or less the same thing, but we have got rid. And now this is strongly connected, so every two items in this, in here, are connected through a path both ways. So then we can make, okay, the former question can be formulated in terms of the diagrams we have here in the following way. Can we find a node, an item, and starting with this node, to cover, to span the whole book? The answer is yes, we can, and this is called the arborescence, the maximal spanning arborescence of this graph, and it turns out, believe it or not, that this term is transversality for this book. That means, if you start with transversality and keep on following methodologically, not ignoring, not disregarding any connectives, you're going to read the whole book. So this is the practical issue. Then I said, okay, let me take, I'm interested in Meyasu. So let me take the Meyasu dictionary and do something similar. I'm not going to say details due to time limitations, but you know, this is, it's a smaller dictionary. So we have 91 keywords. Of course, these are the ones. And then this is the network, the assemblage. Yes, it's smaller, it looks like that. We can do similar things, but what about the root of the last thing of the arborescence? And this for Meyasu is materialism. So if you start with the entrance of materialism in the dictionary edited by Peter Grattan, I guess, and Paul Ennis, then if you start with materialism and follow all the connectives, you can cover the whole book, but without ignoring any relationship, any connective. And then I said the last thing, and I'm very close to finishing, what about joining together these two networks, and the dictionary, the Deleuze dictionary, and the Meyasu dictionary? The reason that they can be coupled together is because we have what Latour taught us that they are called a number of obligatory points of passages. They are bridges. So there are 10, exactly 10 terms, 10 entrances, which are common in both dictionaries. Of course, the content of each one of those is different and written by different people and so forth. I don't know if any of those was written by John. It's not. But anyhow, different people have contributed to both dictionaries, and maybe Jeffrey Bell is in both of them. I'm sure he is in both of them. But you see, the idea is now is to use these common notes, common entrances to dictionaries, as obligatory points of passage to pass from the one network, from the one assemblage to the other one. And this is the picture we see. Let me show you the network. This is from a distance. So if we keep on zooming the other way, by the way, let me explain the colors, okay, even here. The blue colored notes are the entrances of the Deleuze dictionary, and the red colored notes are entrances in the Deleuze dictionary, which are common, they exist with the same exactly name in the Meyesu dictionary. And in the Meyesu dictionary, the yellow colored notes are the Meyesu entrances, and the green colored notes are the other ones. So we can do a similar analysis of access as the one I showed you. But I was interested in a last thing that I would like to show you. I was interested in heterogeneous recurrences. Is it possible to travel, to navigate, crossing both assemblages, starting with one of them? Of course, I know that the articulation points are the common notes, so I have to consider them. And then what I'm going to find then is some sort of cycles. These are the recurrences. So I can try any sort of pairs of these ones, of these common entrances, but what I'm going to show you here, I have tried the notions, does it help me? Yeah. Immanence, because immanence is common in both of them, I'm finishing in less than 1 minute, and materialism. And this is, so I have cycles of length 6, and here they are. Perhaps I need to make it smaller. If I can. What's the problem? I'm not sure why it's not working. Anyhow, let me keep it. Oh, I can do something simpler. I'm finishing in just a few seconds. I can try to rerun it. As I told you, oh, here it is. This is the small one. It's going to reappear here. As I was telling you, this is something I'd like to finish. If you are interested in these notebooks, that you can use them yourselves and do your own sort of navigation in any way you want. I'm sorry, I mean, it disappeared suddenly. Just send me an email, or I can give you access right now from here. Okay, thank you very much.